Hello everyone, welcome to a video on how to import cross-currency receipt in Fusion Receivables by using AutoLockbox. I have a series of three videos on YouTube on how to use AutoLockbox in Fusion Receivables. This is probably a kind of extension of that series of video because I received few requests from different people that how to import cross-currency receipt by using AutoLockbox. That's why I'm making this video. So this is a fourth video, kind of extension of the series of videos what I prepared for AutoLockbox. A detail about that is there in the details of this video, which will be uploaded in YouTube. Having said that, let us start with a little background of the cross-currency receipt. So the setup what I have is, I have the functional currency as Singapore dollar, and we have a AR invoice of amount 8,025 Singapore dollar. Customer sends me a receipt, a check of in USD currency and against this invoice. That means the receipt what I get from customer is of 5,350 USD. Exchange rate is assumed to be 1.5. So 5,350 USD becomes 8,025 Singapore dollar. So when we create this receipt in application, and when we apply this receipt to the invoice, it should settle the particular invoice because the amount in Singapore dollar of the receipt and the invoice is matching. But since invoice currency is, invoice is in SCD, but the receipt is in USD, since currency is different, so it's a cross-currency receipt. There are two methods which we can by which we can create the receipt. We can create manually. Okay, that's out of the scope of this video. Another option, we can import the receipt by using AutoLockbox. That's what we are going to discuss in this video. So let's proceed in with this scenario in application. So I have one invoice. Invoice number is 27001. Amount is 8025. Invoice currency is Singapore dollar. Now, let us see the balance detail of this invoice. So I navigate to action, view balance details. You can see the complete amount is balanced, since nothing has been paid against this particular invoice. So that's what this invoice is. Now, when we create the receipt, so the invoice is of 8025 and the receipt what we are going to create is of 5350. That's what we can see. 8025 divided by 1.5 is 8350. So that's the invoice amount and this is the receipt. And exchange rate is 1.5 USD to Singapore dollar. Now, so this is the AutoLockbox FDDI template. All the details what I'm going to show here is same as what I have shown in my series of videos for the AutoLockbox. Only few details I'm going to change, which will be related to the cross currency receipt. So let us verify the details what we are going to have for each of the record type. So for the first record type one, as such, there is no change. I'm just changing the deposit date. It's 16th October 2021. Invoice, the receipt amount remains 5350. For the record type two, again, deposit date, I will sync up for all the data, all the record types. For the record type five, I'm changing the deposit date. Apart from that, I don't think there is any change. Everything remains same as before. In the record type three, the batch header, I'm simply changing the batch name. Yes, the currency here is USD. In the prior videos, the other video what I have for the AutoLock box, there the currency was Singapore. Now currency here is USD because it's a cross currency receipt. Conversion rate, I'm just saying user as 1.5. So this is the conversion rate for the USD currency. That's USD to the functional currency of the ledger, that is Singapore dollar. Everything remains same, there's no change. Record type six. This here we will have few changes. So batch name, I'm just thinking up. Receipt number, I'm just changing it to some another number because I already have that receipt number in system. Currency is USD. Conversion rate type is user. Exchange rate is 1.5. This is the customer detail of the invoice. Deposit date. Just changing it. The transaction to which this receipt is applied. This is the transaction number of the open invoice. Now, I'm applying 8025 amount. And the receipt I have is of 5350. So the cross currency rate, what I have to give here, it will be 5350 divided by 8025. So that is what I have to give in the cross currency rate. If I calculate this, this will be, I think 0.66 if I'm not wrong. Just do the calculation. Yeah, 0.66. Let me change the value here. 0.66. Applied amount to 8025. So that is it. The overflow, nothing. I don't have an overflow. The batch trader, only the batch name I have to change. Everything remains same. The deposit date, I have to make it 16th of October. That's it. Other sheets, only thing the deposit date I have to change. Everything remains same. Everything remains same to what I have shown in the prior video. So that is it. Data is ready. So now let me prepare the zip file. I will save it to download the machine. Okay. Now let us go to application. We will go to scheduled process. And then we will load the zip file first. So we'll run the program, load import, I think that's it. Program. Yeah, load interface file. So this is the same thing what I have shown in the prior video also. So I will have to just repeat the steps. I select the data file from my local drive. I save this in download folder. Submit. Okay, so the data is loaded. Now we will run the program, process receipts for auto lockbox. That's the name. Through lockbox. We will select the import process ID by which we loaded the data file. We'll give our transmission name, submit import now. We will validate, we'll submit validation, and we will select post, submit post receipt ITS so that everything can be processed in one single click. Submit. It will take a while to complete the process. So in the same run, I'm validating the data as well as I'm doing the post receipt batch also. So it will, if everything goes fine, the receipt will be created and it will be applied to the respective transaction if all the data is proper. So now we have the validation report. That is where we can just verify whether receipt got created or not. So let it complete. Yeah, it is completed now. Let us verify the output. So here it says record was validated, receipt was transferred. If something error happens, then it will say that receipt was transferred will not be there. Now let us verify, since receipt is created, so let us verify the receipt in application. We will go to manage receipts. We know the receipt number, what we have given in the data file. It says SAN 161021. So it got created. You can see. Let us see what is the amount applied. Because of that exchange rate difference, right? Because exchange rate was actually 0.66666, something like that. But I gave only 0.66. So that's why maybe the complete amount is not applied. Something remains as residual. So we have a receipt of 5350. Let me check the amount applied. So let us verify the transaction number is 27001 on which the receipt is applied. That is what expected. Amount due is zero now. Yes. Complete amount got applied. That is what we wanted. So whatever difference is coming, it is because of that difference of actually the cross currency rate was 0.6666. It was not terminating. So that's why this difference has come. So probably if we give 0.67 as a cross currency rate, probably there will not be any exchange gain loss kind of. So that is what I wanted to show, that by using auto lock box, how we can import a cross currency receipt. I hope this video is useful. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye.